वेलकम टू शेठ विद्या मंदिर ऑनलाइन ऑडियो वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज। दिस इज़ योर मैथ्स प्रोफेसर जया शर्मा। विद दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टार्ट विद मैथ्स 1 लेसन नंबर 3 ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी सीइंग ऑल द बेसिक एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट फंक्शंस विच वी नीड टू नो अबाउट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री बिफोर सॉल्विंग द सम। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड।
द लेसन इज ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस। Trigonometric functions, one of the very very important subtopics under calculus mathematics. If you understand the basics of this lesson, all the formulae, the identities, which we have already done in our 10th standards, then this lesson won't be a problem. So let us brush a few things which are very very essential to be known before solving sums. Now very first one is, in this lesson we need to know, or we will be dealing with trigonometric equations. Now what are trigonometric equations? It's just simple. I will take an example as, let's say 3 sine theta plus 1 is equal to 2. So now this becomes a trigonometric equation, just a simple equation. In place of variables we have trigonometric function involved here, so such an equation is called as trigonometric equation. Okay, then next we need to know solution of trigonometric equation. I'll just write it TE, solution of trigonometric equation. Now see, for example, in algebraic equations, if you had 3x plus 4 is equal to 2, so we used to find out 3x is equal to 2 minus 4, that is 2 minus 2, and then x is equal to minus 2 upon 3. So this we used to call x is equal to minus 2 upon 3 as solution of the given equation. Same way in a trigonometric equation, when you will solve for the trigonometric function, the angle involved with the function, that is theta in this case, as in this case, whatever value you will get for theta will be considered as solution of trigonometric equation. Okay, next few more things as values of trigonometric functions. There are 6 functions in all: sine, cos, tan, cot, cosec and sec. Very simple one, I will just give an example to you. Check the table. Now in this table, see, this, we have already seen this in our 10th standard. Let's quickly revise this. How we used to find values of all the different angles for trigonometric functions, as in 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. What we used to do, the trick was from here start numbering, starting with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next step is divide by 4. Each number which you have written divided by 4. Then next step is, what was the answer after dividing it by 4? Here we get 0, here we get 1 upon 4 itself, here we get 1 upon 2, and then here 3 upon 4 itself, and here 1. Okay, so next third step is find out square root of whatever values you have got. That would be your answer. Here 0, 1 upon 4, square root of 1 upon 4 is 1 upon 2, then square root of 1 upon 2 is 1 upon root 2, here root 3 upon 2, and here square root of 1 is 1. Okay, so this will be our value for sine theta, as sine 45 is 1 upon root 2, sine 60 is root 3 upon 2. Okay, now next for writing for cos theta, start from right to left values. This whatever we have got, I'll just write little big here, 1 upon root 2, 1 upon 2 and 0. What I've done, I've just written from right to left here. Next is tan theta. Now tan is also given by sine theta upon cos theta, so we will use this value result here. So 0 upon 1 gives you 0, and then divide this 1 upon 2 upon root 3 upon 2, so we get 1 upon root 3 here, 1, and then root 3 upon 2 divide by 1 upon 2, you get root 3, and here 1 upon 0 not defined. Okay, now same way, now cosec theta, finding values for cosec theta. Okay, now cosec theta is also equal to 1 upon sine theta, so just write reciprocal of this. Okay, 0, 2, root 2, 2 upon root 3 and 1. Then sec theta is reciprocal of cos. So we write here reciprocal of these values, 2 upon root 3, root 2, 2, and then 1 upon 0 we will get here, so right, not defined. Cot is reciprocal of tan, so we will write reciprocal of all values of tan, 1 upon 0, not defined, and then here root 3, 1 upon root 3, and the last one we get 1 upon not defined, take it as 0. Okay, now this was very fine. This is very fine when you are actually practicing in the beginning. Okay, but I'll give you one more trick how you should remember quickly. Just try to fix these two triangles in your mind. I have taken one right angled triangle with 30, 60, 90 triangle like this, and then number the sides like this, 1, 2, root 3. Okay, and then one more, an isosceles right angled triangle we will take with 45, 45, 90 triangle angles in this triangle, and name number the sides as 1, 1, root 2. Okay, now what do you need to do? You see, we know that sine theta is given by opposite upon hypotenuse. So if you're finding sine 60 opposite upon hypotenuse, so you will get sine 60 as root 3 upon 2. Just check here, sine 60 root 3 upon 2. Then tan 45, tan is given by opposite upon adjacent. So tan 45 opposite upon adjacent will give you 1. Let's check it in the table, tan 45, 1. Okay, so you can also remember these two triangles in your mind, and then all the values you can write down on your own. Okay, no need to by heart anything in this. Now let's move further. Now next is about the values of trigonometric ratios in quadrants, different quadrants. Okay, see, when we divide a plane into a Cartesian axis, we get this top right corner one as first quadrant, this one as second quadrant, this one as third quadrant, and this one as fourth quadrant. Now whatever angles are there, 90 180, we need to represent all these angles in terms of radians. So here we get 0 degree, there is 90 degree, that is pi by 2 radians, and then 180 degree, it's pi, and the next one is 270, so that we get as 3 pi by 2. And then again coming back here, when it comes to 360, it is 2 pi. Okay, so it's also 2 pi. I write here 0 degree 2 pi radians. Now suppose you are asked an angle which is more than 90, so that can be represented as 90 plus theta. So when I write here sine 90 plus theta, that means pi by 2 plus theta. So what I will get, you know, 90 plus theta, first of all you need to check out which quadrant it will lie in. So it will come in second quadrant. Okay, and one more thing here, starting from first quadrant and moving anti-clockwise, we name it like this, ASTC, all silver teacups. So this means in first quadrant all trigonometric ratios are positive. In second quadrant, sine and its reciprocal, that is cosec, is positive. Rest all trigonometric ratios are negative here. In third quadrant, tan and its reciprocal cot will be positive. Rest will be negative. And in fourth one, cos and its reciprocal, that is sec, will be positive. Rest all will be negative. Okay, this one more thing we need to remember while writing the values here. So when we have a sine pi by 2 plus theta, so it will fall in second quadrant, and in second quadrant sine is positive. So what we will get answer? We will get sine theta. Okay, now here a question, how I know it will be sine only, why not cos? So you remember one identity in your 10th standard of acute angles, trigonometric functions of acute angles, sine 90 minus theta was cos theta. Then cos 90 minus theta was sine theta. tan 90 minus theta was cot theta. Cot 90 minus theta was given by tan theta. Sec 90 minus theta is equal to cosec theta. And cosec 90 minus theta is equal to sec theta. These were the values which we have seen in our 10th standard. Now pi by 2 minus theta, that is 90 minus theta in first quadrant. So all the angles values will be positive, because in first quadrant all ratios are positive. Okay, now see there, I'll just tell you one trick here, how you will know that when this answer will change the ratio in answer side. Okay, like sine becomes cos and then cos becomes sine, tan becomes cot, and so on. See, it is very easy to remember. Pi by 2 means 90 here. Okay, so whenever it is 90, related to 90, that is y-axis, the angle, the ratio will change, trigonometric ratio will change. So here I write change, and then whenever it is associated with x-axis, we will write no change. Okay, so see, now I hope you have understood this one. When it is sine pi by 2 plus theta, again it is related to y-axis pi by 2. So actually the value here, trigonometric ratio, should change in the answer. So sine pi by 2 plus theta will give you cos theta, not sine theta. Okay, I hope now you have understood this. So let's write down the further ratios. Cos pi by 2, tan pi by 2. See, again I will explain while writing the answer, so you understand how I am considering the change of ratios and how I am considering the sign, which is very important to be understood. Sign while writing the answers, okay? Fine. So while I write pi by 2 plus theta, the which stands in second quadrant, sign is positive in second quadrant, so I get answer also positive. But since it is from y-axis, we have to change the ratio. So I got cos here. Again, cos will become sine. So I get here sine theta. Cos pi by 2 plus theta will give you sine theta. But now let's decide for sine here. I mean convention. Okay, so sine magnitude, what will be? It will be positive or negative. That sign I'm saying. So cos in second quadrant, just check out, sine and cosec is positive. Cos will be negative. So this answer will be negative. Okay. Likewise, tan pi by 2 plus theta will give you cot theta. But again in second quadrant, tan will be negative. So answer will be negative. Cot pi by 2 will give you tan. Again in second quadrant, so it is negative. Sec. Or else here, once you got sine and cos, then it is very easy to write the further answers. Sec is reciprocal of cos here. So sec pi by 2 plus theta will be equal to 1 upon cos pi by 2 plus theta, that is 1 upon minus sine, which gives you minus cosec theta. And then cosec pi by 2 plus theta will be this is reciprocal of sine, 1 upon sine pi by 2 plus theta. So 1 upon cos, it gives you sec theta. See, we will check this one the other way also, how we have learned so far. Cosec pi by 2 plus theta, pi by 2 plus theta in second quadrant. Cosec is inverse of sine, reciprocal of sine, which is positive in second quadrant. So we get positive answer. Okay, this is how we write trigonometric functions for allied angles. I hope now you will be able to write all functions for, let's say, if it is pi plus theta or if it is pi minus theta. See, pi plus theta will come where? Pi plus theta. So it will come here in third quadrant, right? Pi plus theta. And then pi minus theta here in second quadrant. Pi minus theta. So same way here, 3 pi by 2 plus theta, suppose it is. So it will go in fourth quadrant, 3 pi by 2 plus theta. Fine. And then accordingly check out if it is associated with y-axis, in RHS the trigonometric ratio will change. And if it is associated with x-axis, in RHS the trigonometric ratio will not change, fine. So this is how we write values for trigonometric functions for allied angles. Now let's see few more basics which are needed for solving the sums ahead. Now the next is solution of trigonometric equations. While finding the solution, there are two methods in which the solution is obtained. One is known as general solution, and the other is known as particular solution. Okay, now there are few things which we need to remember. Like general solution, your answer will always lie between 0 to 2 pi. Whatever answer you will try to find for theta, that should lie between 0 to 2 pi. Now this is 0 degree and 2 pi is what? 2 into 180, so that is 360 degrees, okay? So you just need to check out whether your answer is lying between 0 degree and 360 degree, then it will be the general solution. And then there is different, the second type of solution which we'll be obtaining is particular solution. We'll see what these two types are while we solve the sums ahead. This we'll see in the next video. For now, please practice the basics so that it becomes easier for us to understand how the sums are being solved. Thank you for watching the video.